Dear audience, my name is Oleksii. I work for Cisco and want to share here my experience with API. A few short story. Yesterday when I come to this venue, I see the sauna door sign before this. I think maybe they forgot to remove it. Then I come out and see wood interior, sauna stove, and think, it's so... it's such a beautiful place, and my wife called me and asked, how are you doing? I say, Efsan, I listening for the speech in the sauna. She asked, oh, you really on the conference? it's very beautiful place and that I ever seen. Okay, the theme is how API will help to win upper hand in the deals regarding case infrastructure API. Cisco has a special program that's called DevNet, so developers can involve in process to create a third-party application using our API of our product and solutions. In our work we have different samples how API can help to win and upper hand the deal and to close the deal. During this presentation, you can see some structuring information regarding preparing API and things around this in order to win a deal. Let's see what we are talking about. Here is our agenda. When API can be an advantage in a deal, when API can be a disadvantage in a deal, stack and technique for quick prototyping, how we in Cisco work with developer communities, and what is infrastructure API. When API can be an advantage in a deal. First of all, it's well-designed API with simplicity documentation and testing capability. Second one is software development kit for various solutions and also ready-to-go integration or different prototypes and services. Third one is community support, like partners, ecosystem, service, support service, and opportunities for learning. It is a bonus when your customer and developers or engineer have a hand to work with it. Second, when you have code samples already to use open source program which can solve to optimize customer issues. And the third one, when you or your partner developer organization can solve some customer requests by creating third-party application, as I said before. As far as Cisco works, like networking, security, collaboration, data centers, many vendors have API and program for developers, but only a few one can draw up correctly and well-structured information and process that they have. Unfortunately, it's impossible to predict what parameters are important in deals for your customer. You have to make and sync up the most comprehensible and easy way to demonstrate to the client necessary information from the documentation to ready-to-go integration. API design affects opportunities. The first and very important detail is the design API. This is a basis upon which all other necessary elements are, such as documentation, example of use, are built up on this. The API design will directly affect parameters like throughput, latency. If you talk about GraphQL, it's important to calculating the maximum execution costs and query depths. You, the developers, need to know how the API are designed, how much time and server resources will collect requests. If you know what a query will be used frequently or to get some information, you need to multiple choice. For example, it's worth redesign or optimizing this information. For example, if you need to get list of configuration of devices, it's better if you have one endpoint, API endpoint, when you can get all the list, and then in your third-party application you can parse it and give those information that you need. or for important changes of some important changes in your device, for example, in security device, like information about compromutations and others, you can create reverse APIs that are well known as webhooks. So important information can be delivered to your application as it happens. Your organization should understand what parameters and data are important for the client. And developers can create useful product for your client or partners. These options can be defined either from the general logic of your product or through the customer service, or if you have the support in your organization, you can take this information there. When API can be a disadvantage in a deal? First of all, it's poor documentation. Second one is buggy software, like program, script, or applications that you shared. The use of API requires additional stuff. For example, a company who want to use your API need to involve some outsource company or additional stuff. But for some companies, very useful if you need to involve other stuff. Additional cost, for example, using your API needed additional license, for example, subscription and others. Stack and techniques for quick prototyping. I share our experience. For quick prototyping, something with front-end part, we use Vue.js. In my opinion, if you compare different JS frameworks, we can see that with Vue.js, you can assemble your prototype faster than using React, for example, or Angular. But Vue.js is hard to maintain, as you know. So be careful with your developers, don't fire them. Regarding techniques, concentrate on the main features and design. It's very important, for example, in infrastructure companies. You need to have an interview, for example, with your customers or send the detailed form that I said after with questions of variance and with variance of answers. And I want to ask you, what stack are you using for prototyping in your work? Can you tell? You don't prototype yet? Don't prototype yet? What stack are you using for prototyping in your company? Stack of technologies.
Well, I don't know if we have a name, it's so heterogeneous. It's like
okay. It means technologies, programming technologies for prototyping. What do you use?
Programming technologies.
Jupyter
notebooks.
Jupyter notebooks. Yeah.
JavaScript.
Node.
Python.
Python.
Depends on what.
Yeah. Also in infrastructure API, Python is also very popular. There are many different libraries for network programmability also. Okay, here is a sample of stack and technique for quick prototyping form that you can see the sample of this form. The form gives you more information for quick prototype instead of statement of work. I show you three, for example, questions. For example, first off, this is choose a preferred channel to receive daily infrastructure reports. And there is a different variant, email, Cisco WebExtreme, SubSlack, Web, GE, ERP system. You need to collect this form for create in short term your prototype, third party application. Actions that can help you. Here you see some table, which activities and program can help you to build a system that makes your API advantage in a deal, in relationship with your customer. And as usual, it means without budget. If you don't have a budget for paid activities, this table can be also relevant for you. In case if you have and can involve in some activities folks who know your API or work with your API. Your employees, partners, or developers who wants to boost up or level up their GitHub can contribute to popular open source project or framework. Thus, engineers, developers, and other staff in the company, in client company, would enjoy open source. First, they don't need to book a budget. It's very important, as I think. Target audience, it will be easier to solve internal issues with the implementation of open source solutions because it can be scalable. Many employees are familiar with some open source framework and others. Regarding infrastructure API, for example, I can tell you a few programs and frameworks that Cisco employees, Cisco partners are contributing. And it popular in our sphere and using sourcebound or northbound API. First is OpenConfig, maybe you heard about this, then Ansible and Network Service Orchestrator. What are business expectations from API? You can prepare a file with API information, your products, and can be automated and integrated with other products. This should demonstrate how to improve overall system performance. This is especially noticeable in the area of security, where is time is responding to compromise is too important. For example, which parameter in which scheme you can quickly integrate with your CIM system, for example, for security devices like firewalls and others. So you have to do all this information about API can positively affect business process is available, so that is another bonuses to customer to choose your product. You can collect this all information and create documentation, demos with this information or videos affecting the parameters that you see on these slides and give it public for your customer. How API can help to work with different types of customer? Let's consider the following types. First, commercial organization, small and middle-sized businesses, public sectors, educational institutions, distributors and partners. For each of these types, somewhat different parameters and capabilities of your API will be critical and important. I give you a few examples and use cases that I have encountered. For example, for commercial organizations, we have some use cases when there will be important opportunities for rapid monitoring and the state of devices in this organization. For small and middle-sized business businesses, for example, we have cases when they need API to ease of management and deployment and possibility of custom management, custom control. For educational institution, in some cases it will be useful if you can integrate your API of your infrastructure in learning process. For distributors and partners, important, for example, some API is connected with monitoring updates, validity of license, and others. What is infrastructure API? First of all, on this scan you can see a modern ecosystem. On this layer you can see application developers, all you have telephones or notebooks, and those programs that are installed there is modern applications. But those parts that have some deal with switch, routers, servers, it's called infrastructure developers, and state on this level like programmable infrastructure. Now many companies open the API from the infrastructure, from switches, routers, servers, as I said before, and you can also programmable this part of infrastructure. Here you can see how we work, for example. To give the best experience and to give possibility to make your infrastructure API as advantages, in deals we offer next. First of all is infrastructure sandbox. Then we have some ecosystem exchange when partners and independent developers can contribute. We have some special solution partner programs. Also, we have useful resources of our company and our partners, like SDK, code samples, learning labs, and the site where communities and partners, employees, can share the open source code. It's very important. Okay, thank you for your full and divided attention. If you want to try infrastructure API, it is for free. Here is a site, developer.cisco.com, and I'll be able to answer the questions.